Well, she's an average schoolgirl during the day, a pop singer at night, and if you have kids, I know you know who we're talking about.
Yeah, that would be Hannah Montana. And right now, she's the hottest ticket in town. But as 11 News reporter John Sherman tells us, getting your hands on tickets to her concert, it's pretty much close to impossible, John.
Yeah, well, Stan, it is close to impossible, and several states' officials are moving to help desperate Hannah Montana fans, but here in Maryland, it appears the law is not on the fans' side.
This is what all the fuss is about, and it's a big deal to fans like 13-year-old Allison Bloom.
Your dad said you even offered to spend your own $300?
Yeah, because I really wanted to go.
So you'd spend your own
$300? Yeah.
But he won't let you.
No.
Allison's dad, Ed, tried to get the tickets online, but Ticketmaster sold out in seconds.
And what was your daughter's reaction when you said, I don't think it's going to work out, we can't go?
Totally disappointed. Very disappointed. Why didn't you get it done? Kind of a little angry at me that I didn't try hard enough, but there was just nothing you could do. You got online instantly at 10 o'clock, and it was just gone.
Faced with similar situations and online resellers charging as much as $2,500 a ticket, the attorneys general in Missouri and Arkansas are taking action. In Missouri, the tour bowed to the pressure and offered 1,000 more seats at face value.
I don't think that they should let that many brokers, like, buy that many tickets so other people can have a chance.
But Maryland's Attorney General's office tells 11 News ticket scalping is not illegal in Maryland in most cases. However, the Attorney General is interested in hearing complaints from anyone who believes there is some illegal activity occurring.
If there's any hope for fans, it may be for the next concert. The Wall Street Journal reports that Ticketmaster is working to crack the software that the online brokers use to dominate those ticket releases. Live at First Mariner Arena, John Sherman, WBAL-TV 11 News.